In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. My dear brothers and sisters, Allahu Akbar, whenever those who have fasted gain the satisfaction of the Merciful. Allahu Akbar, when their souls and bodies are purified in Ramadan through obedience to the Creator. Allahu Akbar, when the person who has fasted sincerely gains forgiveness. Allahu Akbar, when the Muslims are loving and kind to each other, meeting each other with happiness, love and peace. Subhanallah, who planned his creation with his great wisdom. Subhanallah, who created all creations with his supreme power. Subhanallah, who is most compassionate and whose mercy permeates all creations. We thank and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us this Eid al-Fitr. Who has given us this Eid al-Fitr as a gift in the end of the month of Ramadan. And we bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah alone. The one who has filled this day with his blessings and mercy for mankind. We bear witness that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is the true messenger of Allah, the best to please the all-knowing, the all-powerful. We invoke Allah's blessings on him, his family, and noble companions. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Abu Huraira, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, says that he heard the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam saying, when the eve of Eid al-Fitr comes, all the angels rejoice. And Allah Almighty says, Ya malaikati, O my angels, ma jaza'u al-amil alladhi kammal amal. Yaqulun jaza'u an yudfa' lahu ajr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks his angels, O my angels, what is the reward of those laborers who have completed their task? The angels reply that they should be fully rewarded. Allah Almighty says, Ishhadu fa inni qad ghafartu lahum. Ishhadu fa inni qad ghafartu lahum. Be a witness, I have forgiven them all. May Allah include all of us among those. Umama al-Bahili radiallahu ta'ala narrates a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, anyone who keeps alive the two nights of Eid, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, by remaining awake in the worship of Allah, his heart will not die on that day when every heart will be dead. من أحيا ليلتي العيد بالعبادة لن يموت قلبه يوم الذي تموت فيه القلوب. It's very significant. We need to understand and we need to utilize this time to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. My dear brothers and sisters, Salatul Fitr is wajib to every Muslim on whom Zakat is fard according to some of the scholars. But majority of the scholars, they say that it is wajib on everyone who has food of one day and night. He has to pay Salatul Fitr for himself and on behalf of whoever he has in his family, all the members, he is responsible for that. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ. My dear brothers and sisters, if we look back at our history, we see that we have gone very far as a Muslim Ummah. And there are reasons for it. There was a time when Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu stood up in Medina. And he said, لَوْ مَاتَ الْكَلْبُ عَلَى فُرَاتِ. one dies from Frat, from the edge of Frat, out of hunger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask me on the Day of Judgment about that dog. Then there was a time of Harun al-Rashid. Muslim Ummah was so much blessed that he used to address the clouds by saying, اِذْهَبِي حَيْثُ شِئْتِ فَإِنَّكِ سَتَأْتِينَ بِغَرَامِكِ. You know, when he would see clouds going away, he would address them, tell them, go away the way you want. You will have to come back with the fine. You will have to bring more rain. That's how Muslim Ummah was, my dear brothers and sisters. And if you look at the history, there are many Mu'tasim Billahs. There are many rulers who have taken the responsibility of the Ummah. They tried to fulfill their responsibility at their utmost. But the situation is not like that today. We are all, as Ummah, degraded in every nook and corner of the world. Is that the situation is entirely hopeless? Is there really nothing we can do? We can do a lot. If we cannot do anything, we can at least pray for the brothers and sisters who are suffering. We can use our skills and resources to support them as much we can. We need to use our time, our money, and our skills and all resources to strengthen ourselves and our community, my dear brothers and sisters. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. My dear brothers and sisters, this Eid has some wisdom behind it. It is definitely a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And among those wisdoms which are behind this is that we as Muslims, we need to understand the real meaning of brotherhood. And we need to bring our hearts closer. And we need to visit each other. And we need to extinguish the fire of malice and envy and hasad and jealousy among us. This is the time when a person whom you have anything against him in your heart, you go and say salam to him and ask him for his forgiveness. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. My dear brothers and sisters, having mercy, love for others, and helping them is a sifa of a mu'min. Bukhari narrates a hadith from Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَبَارَكِهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ الْوَاحِدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عُضْمٌ تَدَاعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالْحُمَّى وَالسَّهْرَةِ. The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, example of mu'mineen among themselves in their brotherhood, in their love to each other and mercy, it is just like one body. If any part of the body suffers, the whole body suffers. So my dear brothers and sisters, having love between Muslims is one of the main purposes of the Risala of Anbiya alayhi wa salatu wa salam. And how can that love prevail among us? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us very beautiful prescription for it. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, La tadkhul al-jannata hatta tu'minu. La tadkhul al-jannata hatta tu'minu. You will never enter Jannah until you believe in oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prophethood of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam. وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُّوا. And you cannot be a complete mu'min until you love each other. Just like the previous hadith, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَارِدِهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ الْوَاحِدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عُضْوٌ تَدَاعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالْحُمَّى وَالسَّهَرَةِ. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أَفَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ.
Do you want me to inform you about a very simple thing which can create love between all of you? And he said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. Qal afsha salam baynakum. Say salam to each other. Even if you do not know that brother, say salam to each other. People always ask a question, can we say salam to non-Muslims? There were Sahaba who used to go to the market and without any difference between Muslim and non-Muslim, they used to say salam. You know, sometimes somebody was telling me the story the other day that somebody came and said salam in a public gathering to Muslims and he was not Muslim. He said, you don't say salam and we don't say salam to you. That's not the behavior of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he did not want us to do that. So we need to strive hard to clean our hearts and remove all the malice and jealousy and envy and hasad from our hearts, because that is the best person. If you look at Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu ta'ala an, about whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a clear hadith that he is from the people of Jannah, he had nothing to offer but one thing, that his heart was clean. And he said, before I go to bed, I forgive everyone, no matter how much he violated my right. I forgive him. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi hamd. Clean heart and purified heart is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters. A person whose heart is not clean, he cannot be forgiven. His dua is not accepted. His istighfar is not answered. His prayers are not answered. Abdullah ibn Amr radiallahu ta'ala narrates a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Qila ya Rasulullah. Some people ask the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, ayyul nasi afdal. Tell us who is the best among all of us. قال كل مخموم القلب صدوق اللسان. كل مخموم القلب صدوق اللسان. Every مخموم القلب and truthful person is the best person. قالوا فما مخموم القلب يا رسول الله. Sahaba asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, what is مخموم القلب? What do you mean by مخموم القلب? قال هو التقي النقي لا إثم فيه ولا بغي ولا غل ولا حسد. رواه ابن ماجه. That is a person whose heart is pure, clean. There is no sin, and there is no enmity in his heart, and there is no cheating in him, and there is no hasad about other brothers and sisters in his heart. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi hamd. My dear brothers and sisters, the root cause for all the sins we commit and we go away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is nothing but love of the dunya. There is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, سَيَأْتِي زَمَانٌ عَلَى النَّاسِ يُحِبُّونَ خَمْسًا وَيَنْسَوْنَ خَمْسًا. There will be a time when people will love five things and will forgive, will forget five things. They will love five things and they will forget five things. They said, what are these things, Ya Rasulullah? The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, يُحِبُّونَ الدُّنْيَا وَيَنْسَوْنَ الْآخِرَةِ. يُحِبُّونَ الدُّنْيَا وَيَنْسَوْنَ الْآخِرَةِ. They will love dunya and they will forget the akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says very clearly in the Quran, وَلَا تَكُولُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Second thing, يُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ وَيَنْسَوْنَ الْحِسَابِ. They will love wealth, but they will forget that they are accountable in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tomorrow for all their earnings and where they have spent all that money. يُحِبُّونَ الْخَلْقِ وَيَنْسَوْنَ الْخَالِقِ. They will love creation. They will love creation, but they will forget the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We, instead of loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have started loving His creations. يُحِبُّونَ الْقُصُورِ وَيَنْسَوْنَ الْقُبُورِ. They will love palaces and they will forget their graves. يُحِبُّونَ الذُّنُوبِ وَيَنْسَوْنَ التَّوْبَةِ. They will love to commit sins, but they will forget that there is tawbah after that. So my dear brothers and sisters, this hadith itself, only one hadith, should be enough for us to wake us up from the coma and straighten our life and connect our relationship and make it stronger and strengthen it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Barakallahu li wa lakum. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.